So the way to do that is what we call a procedure. And a procedure is something that takes inputs in. There can be more than one. Does some work on those inputs and produces outputs as results. And the idea of a procedure is a very powerful idea. This allows us to use a small amount of code to do many different things. We can have the same code operate on different inputs. Whatever we pass in as the inputs to the procedure will be what that code operates on, and it can do different things depending on those inputs, and it produces outputs that tell us the result based on the inputs that we passed in. You've seen things very similar to procedures in the previous unit. You saw the built-in operators like plus. Plus took two numbers as its inputs, and as its output, it produced the sum of those two numbers. Because it's a built-in operator, it's a little different from a procedure. The syntax that we use for it is different because it's a built-in operator. But in terms of being something that abstractly operates on different inputs and produces the corresponding output, it's very much the same idea. What we're going to learn in this unit is how to make our own procedures. Python provides a construct for doing that, and the grammar is to have the keyword def, that's short for define, followed by a name. And the name of a procedure is just like the name of a variable. Can be any string that starts with a letter, can be followed by letters and numbers and underscores. Anything that we could use as a variable, we can use as the name of a procedure. Then there's a left paren. The left paren is very important. That's what makes it a procedure. And after the left paren, we have a list of parameters. And parameters is just a fancy name for the inputs to the procedure. After that, there's a colon. This is what says we're making a procedure. It has this name. It takes these inputs. Then what we have to do is actually define the code. And so what follows that is a block. And a block is just a sequence of statements, the code that we want to run as the body of the procedure. What the inputs are is just a list of names separated by commas. We can have as many inputs as we want. There could be no inputs. In that case, what the parameters would look like is just two parens with nothing between them. There could be one input. In that case, we'd have a paren followed by a name, followed by a closed paren. Or there could be many inputs, in which case we'd have a paren followed by the name of the first input, followed by the name of the second input, followed by the name of the third, followed by as many inputs as we want. So we could have five inputs, give them the names A, B, C, D, E. This is not a good idea, usually, to give our parameters meaningless names. That makes it hard to remember what they are when we use them in the code that we write as the block. We're much better off having parameters with names like page that remind us what they mean. The body of the procedure is the block. This is the code that runs to execute the procedure. The block is indented inside the definition. Usually we like to use four spaces. That's just the convention in Python, and that makes it easy for people to see and read the code. But all the lines in the block have to be indented the same amount. And that's how the interpreter knows that we've got to the end of the procedure when we get to some code that's not indented anymore.